This episode is supported by Squarespace.
I don't know how anyone gets up this early. It's so bright.
It's 11 a.m.
Still bright.
I've always been a night owl. So do you prefer to stay up late and sleep in? Or do you go to bed early and get up early too? Maybe you're somewhere in between. So this is called your chronotype, and for a long time, scientists have wondered why we see such a variation between people, and then what sort of effects this has on your health. Luckily, we're waking up to some answers. That was a bit corny. For starters, the moment you feel like you should be going to bed appears to be influenced by your genetics. And this wasn't discovered by a university or a traditional research institution. It's the work of the personal genetic analysis company 23andMe. A quick footnote, you met 23andMe before in a previous episode when you found out that I'm very white. Very white. They did sponsor that episode, but they're not sponsoring this one. They looked at DNA from over 100,000 people who sent in spit samples and then answered surveys. One survey question asks participants if they're naturally a morning or night person. And then by comparing the DNA of the night owls to the morning people, the company found 15 genetic variants linked to chronotype. And these differences aren't just hanging out in random places in the genome. About half of these genetic variants were near genes linked to your body's internal clock, its circadian rhythm. Others were near genes involved in sensing light, and this makes sense when you're talking about natural sleep cycles. And it also means that whether you prefer to stay up late or get an early start, you were probably born with that tendency. It's in your DNA. But this is a point where I grew a bit skeptical because my mum and dad both get up super early, so I can't blame them for this. Beyond your genes, other aspects of your biology and physiology are also related to your chronotype. For example, people tend to wake up earlier as they get older, and generally, women are more likely to be morning people than men. But there's a lot more to it than that. One study looked at the brains of night owls versus morning people and found that people who prefer to stay up late have lower levels of white matter stability in certain areas of the brain. White matter is made of the parts of brain cells that are covered in fatty myelin sheaths. The myelin allows signals to be sent quickly from one brain region to another and gives the white matter its color. The study found differences between night owls and early risers that imply a form of chronic social jet lag for people who naturally stay up later. And if you look at personality differences between morning and evening people, this makes sense.
Sometimes I feel like I'm always jet lagged, so at least now I can call it chronic social jet lag. Sounds like a better excuse.
Morning people tend to be more cooperative, agreeable, conscientious, and proactive. They're also just happier on average. Night owls, on the other hand, have a higher risk for depression. They eat more than morning people, and the type of food they eat is less healthy. They're more likely to abuse nicotine and alcohol, and they're at higher risk for things like sleep apnea. Luckily, there are also perks. So on average, night owls are smarter and they have more intercourse, more interpersonal relations. Both groups show the highest aptitude for problem solving when they're naturally the most awake, and their highest levels of creativity during their less alert hours, whenever that may be.
Here's another footnote if you would like to watch this video and find out when that is for you.
Overall, whether you wake up and go to bed early or late, neither is going to make you healthier, wealthier, or wiser. Sorry, Ben Franklin. Finally, because evolutionary biology just has its own way of explaining everything. One study says variations in sleeping patterns may exist to make it more likely that someone will be awake and on watch in case there's a predator or other emergency. Since my dog and I both sleep until 10 a.m, it's really not that relevant in my house. We're both just sitting ducks. So I'm interested to know if you are a night owl or a morning person and how that's changed over the course of your life. Contact me.
Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this episode. Whether you need a domain, a website, or an online store, you can use Squarespace to make your next move. They have a whole bunch of templates so you can drag and drop and set up your website. There's nothing for you to ever patch or upgrade ever, so you can sleep more. Go to squarespace.com/braincraft to start your free trial and use the offer code BrainCraft to get 10% off your first purchase. This is the largest coffee I've ever seen. I love America.